Hi everyone, welcome to Channel Logics. Hope all you guys are preparing well and staying safe at your home. Since we have started our online classes, in this 1 year span of time, we have trained several thousands of students preparing for various competitive exams. If you want to meet our expert faculty team, you can meet our expert faculty team and we are going to come across with best and unique content which will help you to crack your examinations in a smart way. We are going to teach each and every subject very clearly in detail. And we are going to come across with best and smart approaches which will help you to crack your examinations in very short span of time. Our expert faculty team is going to teach you each and every subject very clearly in detail. If you want, you can join our free foundation batch. This free foundation batch, you need not pay any money for this. And in this free foundation batch, you can meet our expert faculty team who are going to teach each and every subject very clearly in detail. If you have any doubts, you can contact us through these numbers. And we welcome you to be part of Chandan Logics. Thank you.
Hi everyone, welcome back to Chandan Logics. Today we'll be discussing 26th and 27th September current affairs. So first, let us start our class with the practice session. What are the topics we have discussed in our previous class? So based on that, model questions will be given for you. And as well as, before going to start our class, I want to say one thing. If you want to download PDFs of current affairs, so go through Telegram channel. Even link is also provided in description. Once you go through it, to get the access of free PDFs of current affairs on daily basis. And as well as, if you want to watch Telugu current affairs, go through Chandan Logics Telugu channel. So in that, as well as however we are discussing in our English language, so the same will be discussed in your Telugu classes also. Is it clear? So if you are unaware about the channel and as well as about the current affairs regarding that, so even we are providing in Telugu language, so once you go through it. And if you want to share your friends, so you can share to your friends, that will be helpful for them. Let us start our session with the practice question. So first we'll look into the question regarding World Pharmacist Day, which is celebrated annually on which day. So while we are going through important days, the concept you have to concentrate here is about date, theme and what is the objective. Is it clear? So if we move to the objective, once again for your revision purpose, I'm saying that this World Pharmacist Day, which we'll be celebrating to bring the awareness among the people regarding the role of a pharmacist plays in a role that is improving the health of a person, right? That means improving the health of a patient. This is the main objective to celebrate this World Pharmacist Day. Then moving to the date actually. What is the date? Okay, which day actually this World Pharmacist Day will be celebrated? 23rd September, 24th September, 25th September or 22nd September. So try to mention your answer and as well as fourth week analysis of your answers is going on. So I hope so. If your comments will be good, so on October 1st, I'm going to announce this whole week and nearly 10 days of September, fourth week current affairs of your practice question answers will be analyzed and your top comments will be mentioned on October 1st or 2nd. Is it clear? Next. If we move to the second question, that is regarding the world's highest electric vehicle charging station, which has been inaugurated in which state? So you can see while we are coming across these type of concept, so you have to focus actually what is the concept is major about. So this is about electric vehicle charging station, right? And as well as you have to consider even the location, that means in which state or union territory. Is it clear? So sometimes there is a chance to raise the question on countries also. Is it clear? So this is world's highest electric vehicle charging station. Is it clear? World's highest. So there is even a chance to raise the country name also. So try to cover along with the state name and as well as country name. So if we look into the options about the state, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Assam, Himachal Pradesh or Tripura. Next, regarding this actually, why we are covering this concept about Antyodaya Divas, right? So the recognition, celebration of this Antyodaya Divas marks the birth anniversary of which Indian leader? So you can see here actually half the model questions will be done, right? That means from certain topic how the questions will be raised. I think with this question you have got the clarity regarding this Antyodaya Diwas, that means regarding the important days also there is a chance to raise the question in this format. Not only the date, not only the theme and objective, but also here you can see actually this marks the birth anniversary of who. This also comes under the objective, right? Next, if you move to the options, Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay, Ram Manohar Lohia, Shyam Prasad Mukherjee or Jnaneshwar Mishra. Next, Indian Army will organize Bijoya Sanskritik Mahotsav from 26th to 29th September in which state, or you can see place. Is it clear? Bangalore, Kolkata, Dehradun or Leh. You have to concentrate here. Actually, this Bijoya Sanskritik Mahotsav, what is the main objective? So, along with this answer, try to mention in comment section about the reason, or else you know the objective of celebrating this Bijoya Sanskritik Mahotsav from 26th to 29th September at a certain place. Okay, so mention along with the option as well as the reason to celebrate this Bijoya Sanskritik Mahotsav. That means what is the historical significance to celebrate this day, that too Indian Army why it is celebrating, because this concept already we have discussed in our previous class. Is it clear? Next, who has been appointed as WHO ambassador for global health financing? This is regarding appointments. So while you are coming across appointments, you have to concentrate on the name of the person and as well as organization, or else some certain institute, what is the person appointed, or else you can see portfolio. Then moving to the part history of a person who has recently appointed, and even the static part regarding the portfolio or else organization or else the institute. So these are the major areas you have to concentrate while we are discussing about appointments. So at least while we are doing practice questions, you have to get an overview. Okay, from certain topic, these are the type of questions and model questions which were rising from our concepts. Is it clear? Then if we move to options actually about the WHO ambassador for global health financing, David Cameron, Theresa May, Tony Blair or John Major Gordon Brown. Next, moving to the concept regarding important days only, as we have said that objective, date and theme, right? So coming to the part here, the question is all about theme of World Pharmacists Day of 2021. If we move to options actually, transforming global health, safe and effective medicines for all. So here you have to relate actually what is with the meaning of actually a pharmacist. Pharmacist is a person who is professionally trained. Is it clear? That is for the preparation of medicinal drugs, or else you can see supplying of these medicinal drugs. Is it clear? So this is the major role which was played by pharmacist. The theme is here, pharmacy always trusted for your health. Pharmacists are your medicine experts. So if you consider here, this all will be relating certain for the pharmacist, right? But you have to concentrate that specific year 2021, what is the theme for this pharmacist day. If you are unaware of that, of these questions, once you go through our previous class current affairs of 25th September, so you will get to know all the questions and answers very clearly, because whatever the questions I am giving in your practice session, that topics have already discussed in our previous class descriptive session. Is it clear? So now with this we have done with our practice questions of 26th and 26th September. Now we will be moving to our descriptive session. So the first topic we will be covering under national news. So you can see actually this is a topic already we have come across, is it clear, in our previous classes. That is about Prime Minister Modi addresses 76th United Nations General Assembly in New York. As we have discussed that Prime Minister Modi is going for a 3-day visit to US, right? So in that concept only we have covered that he is also going to address United Nations General Assembly 76th session, right? So now it is the time to discuss about that. This came into the scenario about the 76th session of United Nations General Assembly. So first you have to know the static part of United Nations General Assembly. Actually this is one of the 6 principal organs of United Nations, right? And also, this is a policy making and as well as representative organ of these six organs of United Nations. And you can see here, there is an equal representation of all the member states of United Nations General Assembly. And this is only the organ which will treat all the member states and having the equal representation. So, this is a major concept and static part regarding United Nations General Assembly. And now for this 76th session, which was took place in New York. So, Prime Minister Modi has addressed this meeting. And as well as, he is the first world leader scheduled to address the United Nations General Assembly at 6:30 p.m. as per Indian Standard Time. So, you can see here, prior to this, Prime Minister Modi had addressed United Nations General Assembly in the year 2019. Is it clear? Now, 2021, that is 76th session. And along with this, you have to concentrate, actually, what is the theme for this 76th session of United Nations General Assembly? So, for this session of 2021, the theme is all about building resilience through hope. That is mainly to recover from COVID-19 and rebuild the sustainability and as well as responding for the needs. That is, you can see, considering of planet and as well as respect the rights of people and revitalize the United Nations. So, this is the theme of 76th United Nations General Assembly session. Then, moving to the part here, as a part of general terminology, you have to know the full form of IST. Is it clear? So, try to mention the full form of IST. Actually, what does IST represents? So, a little bit information you have to know. So, after the class, just once you go through about IST. Is it clear? Then, if possible, try to mention the answer in comment section, some of the few points regarding IST. So, that if any of them are you aware in the comment section, so at least some of the students can go through it. Is it clear? Next. If we move to the other concept regarding national news, India's clean energy commitments at United Nations Summit. So, here you have to focus clean energy, that is regarding even hydrogen machine and as well as renewable energy, and you can see solar energy. So, actually renewable energy we are considering. What is meant by actually renewable energy? So, these some of the examples if you see wind energy, solar energy, even hydro energy, hydroelectric electricity, right, we used to say. So, these all comes under the clean energy and as well as you can see like renewable energy. Then, moving to the actual our topic is about the clean energy commitments, that is India's commitment towards this clean energy at UN summit. Then what are the commitments? What are the targets of India? Now we will going to discuss. So first if you see during the first leader level meeting on energy, that is under the UN General Assembly, as just now we have discussed about UNGA 76 session, right? So here under this only, this is the first leader level meeting of energy regarding. So, the first commitment of India is about to increase renewable energy installed capacity to 450 gigawatts by 2030. So, you can see here, this is a target which was set by India. For what is the first one category comes under? To increase renewable energy capacity by the year 2030. Next comes to the part about the second commitment is regarding, so you have to focus, first commitment is about renewable energy and second commitment is regarding to develop and implement at National Hydrogen Energy Mission in order to boost the green hydrogen production by the year 2030. This is the second commitment is about green hydrogen production. Is it clear? Next, coming to the third commitment. So, it has also announced to start a production linked incentive scheme. So, this incentive scheme which is going to work on help in adding 10 gigawatts of solar photovoltaic manufacturing capacity. What is the third one? Solar photovoltaic manufacturing, and this is the capacity should be increased by the year 2025. So, you have to concentrate what are the three commitments which were made under United Nations General Assembly Summit, okay, first leaders summit, and that too about the clean energy. And these are the commitments made by India. Is it clear? So, you have to concentrate renewable energy, that is to increase by 450 gigawatts by the year 2030. Second one comes to green hydrogen production by the year 2030, they should increase. Then what is the third one regarding solar photovoltaic manufacturing by 2025? Is it clear? So make it clear and just make a running notes for these type of points. Is it clear? So while you are going through a revision, this will be helpful for you in an easy way. Next, KVIC setups. What is the first silk yarn production center? So actually, what does first KVIC represent? As we have discussed in our previous classes, if you are following my classes from starting itself, so you can cover, and I think you are already you are having a notes of KVIC. So KVIC is a Khadi and Village Industries Commission. So this KVIC now has set up a silk yarn production center that is in the state of Odisha. Actually, Odisha's significance is about there is a major production of silk. Is it clear? And also, if you see, by setting up these type of production centers, so in that state, so there will be two advantages. That means economic growth will be there in a particular area, and as well as what is the second concept you can see. So how the economic growth will be done, so that the employment, is it clear? So even they are generating the employment in these production centers for the local youths, you can see, right? So these are the two main advantages by establishing and by setting this type of production centers. So now if you move, actually this has started a historic initiative to set up first ever, what is the type of silk you can see here, Tusa Silk Yarn Production Center at Chowder in Cuttack district in Odisha. And as well as this will ensure actually about the local availability of this Tusa silk yarn, and as well as reduce the production cost and create the local employment. Is it clear? This is the main objective and why they have set up. Okay, there will be some reason, right? So this is the reason to set up this KVI, that is mainly the step to taken by whom? By KVIC, Khadi Village Industries Commission. And as well as you can see actually why they have considered this Tusa silk, then what is the reason behind it? So why? Because Tusa silk is one of the finest varieties of silk, and as well as it is distinguished by its coarseness and as well as porous weave and giving it a rugged and rustic appearance. So these are the significant sign features of Tusa silk. That means there is a chance to raise the question, even the static part also. That means they'll give the question in the manner like, Tusa silk is having the following features. Is it clear? Then which option is not a feature of Tusa silk? If you know all the features, then you can eliminate those, and which is not a feature of this Tusa silk, you can answer it. That means there is a chance to raise the question in indirect format also. So at least if you know the features perfectly, then you can answer however the question will be raised. Is it clear? So the features of Tusa silk also you have to come across. Then you have to concentrate, actually this production center is capable of producing 200 kgs of silk yarn, which is a worth of 94 lakh rupees annually. So this is the target, and you can see the income, that means economic growth of that country, how it will be going on. That means here only with this production center 94 lakh rupees will be annually the production will be done. So these are the objectives they have considered, and KVIC have come and took the decision regarding this production center. So that production center is regarding what? Silk yarn production center in the state of Odisha. Next, if we move to international current affairs, China declares all cryptocurrency transactions illegal. So as we have come across about cryptocurrencies, right? So some of the example, if you take, in our previous class we have discussed about Bitcoin, right? So Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency. So now not only Bitcoin, but whatever all are there regarding this cryptocurrencies. So now China has took the decision regarding this cryptocurrency, all the cryptocurrencies were illegal. Then what is the reason to ban these? Okay, we will be discussing now in our class. So first, if you see, the global values of actually cryptocurrencies, even including bitcoins, have massively fluctuated during this 2020 and 21 partially. This is due to Chinese regulation and prevent the speculation and money laundering. If you see, according to the People's Bank of China, what is the name of the bank? People's Bank of China. So according to this, there are some of the regulations. So that regulation is, virtual currency which is related to business activities are illegal financial activities. Is it clear? So this is one of the regulation of People's Bank of China. Then offenders will be investigated for criminal liability in accordance with this law. So that is about this illegal financial activities, that is about the virtual currency. Then if we move to the part about the reason, okay, significance or the ban of for China. So cryptocurrency, actually this crackdown was opened the gates for China to introduce, and you can see here China is on the way to produce its own digital currency. So that is why you can see this crackdown will be helpful for China for the creating of their own digital currency, and that whatever the digital currency they are going to provide, so that production will be and the supply will allow the central government of China to monitor these transactions. That means whatever the digital currency by their own central government they are establishing, so only that currencies will be under the central government and to monitor those transactions. But remaining all cryptocurrencies were illegal. This is the decision and declaration was given by China. And if you see, actually this cryptocurrency creation and as well as trading, not only now, that means in 2021 actually about all cryptocurrencies were illegal, the decision has been taken. But even cryptocurrency creation and as well as trading, is it clear? So this decision was already took in the year of 2019. Is it clear? This has already been illegal in China since 2019, but now the complete declaration they have given. Is it clear? That means even including bitcoins also, because many of the countries are considering even bitcoin, that means cryptocurrency, as a national currency, right? So but here China comes to the part, because the major reason is even China is producing its own digital currency. So this is the main concept you have to concentrate here. Next, Italy recognizes India's Covishield vaccine. Is it clear? First you have to see that you have concentrate Covishield vaccine. This is against the coronavirus, which was jointly developed, as we have discussed in our previous like starting classes itself about this Covishield and Covaxins, right? So here this is jointly developed by Oxford University and Pharmagence AstraZeneca, while it was named and manufactured by the Serum Institute of India, right? So we have came across this many times. Covishield was developed by Serum Institute of India, and with this recognition actually by Italy, Indian card holders inoculated by Covishield vaccine and as well as now be eligible to get an Italian green pass. Actually here you have to know a certain little bit about Italian green pass. Actually here green pass, which is the main objective, you can see, which aims to free movement. Is it clear? And here the individuals who exemption of the restrictions that from travel within the European region, that is EU. Is it clear? Within that European region, now the individuals were exempted. So that is all about green pass. And also actually this you can see recognition in Italy regarding the Covishield vaccine. So this has come into the scenario when it is Health Minister Mansukh Mandavia was on the visit in Rome, that is in Italy, for G20 health ministers meeting. So for this meeting when he has attended, so they have come across with this Italian green pass that should be even provided for a Covishield vaccine, that will be for whom? For Indian card holders. Is it clear about Italian green pass? So this is a decision came across the during the meeting of G20 health ministers meeting. Next, if we move to the concept about books and authors, so the first you have to concentrate, while we are discussing about books and authors, you have to concentrate actually about the title of the book. Next, what is the second concept you have to go across about the author? If there is any certain background regarding the author, you have to go across. If not, it is not necessary, just know the author name, that is enough. Then moving to the part, what is the third concept you have to focus actually in that book, what the author is going to describe. Is it clear? That means after reading this book, what are the outcomes you have to know. So these are three areas you have to concentrate while we are doing and while we are discussing about books and authors. The first concept you have to concentrate is about the title. That the title is Fractured Himalaya, How the Past Shadows, that is the Present in India-China Relations. So this is the title of the book, and in the title itself you have to know What is that? About the past shadows and present situation, that is in India and China relations, which is authored by Nirupama Rao. So here the author name is Nirupama Rao. Then you have to concentrate, what does actually this book represents? Is it clear? So the book traces how the origins of the disputes between India and China. This is form a part of living history and event that shapes their fractious relationship today. That is between the relationship between India and as well as China. Is it clear? So how like the disputes were originated? So everything will be going to discuss. Then actually you have to know about Nirupama Rao, who like about the author. So is there any historical background of the person? Yes. You can see Nirupama Rao is a former foreign secretary. Is it clear? Former foreign secretary. So because of this reason, the person is able to know and the person is able to discuss and describe all the origins, even the disputes between India and China. And even with this, you can see understanding the complex about the panorama yields lessons for all of us who seek a wider perspective on China and its profile on in the Indo-Pacific region. So these are the two major concepts in this book the author is going to describe. Is it clear? And the historical background, sometimes you have to concentrate about the author. Nirupama Rao is a former foreign secretary. Is it clear? Next, if we move to state news, you have to concentrate here. This is an important concept. Already we have discussed about geographical indication tag. So that is GI tag. Is it clear? So this geographical indication tag, actually, what are the benefits? Is it clear? For certain product, they will be getting right geographical indication tag. Then, what will be the benefits? So, actually, first you have to know what is geographical indication tag. So, this is mainly given for a product or else food produce which is based on its origin. Is it clear? Geographical origin. And as well as that product has possessed some qualities of that origin. So that is why it has considered and recognized based on the features and qualities of a product as a geographical indication tag. Actually, first this came into the force, geographical indication tag, in the year 2003. Is it clear? Then in 2004 to 2005, actually the first GI product in India is Darjeeling tea. What is the first product in India got the GI tag? That is Darjeeling tea. This is the first product to get the GI tag between the year of 2004 to 2005 approximately. Is it clear? Then what are the benefits of getting this GI tag, after getting this GI tag for the product? So here, to prevent, there is a prevention for unauthorized use of that product by the other persons. And as well as here, because of getting this GI product, that means GI tag for certain product, there will be a value even in other countries also. That means here exports will be increased and here India's economy will be developed. If the exports will be improved, then India's economy will be improved. Is it clear? So these are the major benefits by getting a GI tag for a food produce or else you can see some of the GI products. Is it clear? Then now if you see actually about recently, it is in a scenario and it is in current affair about the geographical indication tag which has recently secured is Naga cucumber, and this is Nagaland sweet cucumber which was awarded geographical indication tag as an agriculture product and under the provisions of geographical indications of, actually first it was came into the scenario with the act called Geographical Indication of Goods Registration and Protection Act of 1999. Actually here you can see protection, right? So this protection act, that means here whatever the product is acquiring this GI tag, so even for that products there will be a legal protection. Is it clear? So this is all about geographical indication tag which was certainly recently received by this Nagaland sweet cucumber. Then actually, what are the features of this sweet cucumber? If you see, this is recognized for its sweetness and unique green color. You can see the image also, and as well as it is rich in potassium and has low calories. By considering these features and the origin of evolution, so they have considered and they have given recently as a geographical indication tag for Nagaland sweet cucumber. And apart from this, you can also know this is one of the most important crops in northeastern region. Is it clear? And Nagaland has a fifth highest cultivation of this fruit area wise and ranks third in the production. So you have to concentrate even these numerical terms. fifth highest cultivation. Then coming to the part regarding production, so this is third. Is it clear? So these are the numerical concepts you can cover here. That means sometimes there is a chance to raise a question. Next, if we move to awards and honors, 75 Divyangan have facilitated with the Hunar Bas Awards. Actually, you have to concentrate first. This award ceremony was organized to commemorate Antyodaya Divas, as we have discussed in our previous class about Antyodaya Divas, right? So this is mainly marking the birth anniversary of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay and also a part of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. So, a part of this and also to commemorate this day called Antyodaya Divas. Actually, this award ceremony was done. Then, if you move across National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayat Raj, that is under the Hyderabad, under the Ministry of, so what is the portfolio you have to concentrate regarding this Hunar Bas Awards? The ministry is all about Ministry of Rural Development, which presented the Hunar Bas Awards to 75 differently abled candidates from 15 states, okay. So there is a chance to raise the question for how many like differently abled person this 2021 these Hunar Bas Awards were given. What is the numerical term here you have to concentrate? It is 75 differently abled candidates and from how many states? That is from 15 states. Then if you see actually about these awards, is it clear? That means for whom this Hunar Bas Awards will be given. These awards will have been designed and for the candidates who were actually trained under this Deen Dayal Upadhyay, that is Gramin Kaushal Yojana and as well as Rural Self-Employment Training Institute scheme. Is it clear? So for those person who were trained under these, okay, for those persons and also not only trained but also have got placed and worked for 1 year in that organization, then for that type of persons from 15 states, now this year for 75 differently abled persons, they have given this Hunar Bas Awards. And the major, you can see the ministry in various states, is it clear? And these are the schemes. More than 1 year successfully settled in that trade and of their choices as a self-employed. So this is mainly for differently abled persons, the Divyangans, is it clear? And as a part of this, you can see how actually Paralympic Games, how many Indian athletes have won. Is it clear? So even the differently abled, that cannot stop you to reach your goals. Is it clear? So this is a major concept you have to focus, that nothing will be stopped to reach your goal. So just you have to keep concentrate and always keep working towards it. So one fine day that will be going to work out and it will pay off to your hard work. Next, if we move to important days, World Tourism Day celebrated on 27th September. Actually, we have came across these many times. That means regarding the tourism sector, how tourism sector plays an important role in country's economy, right? So as a part of, you can see this is a pandemic situation from 2020, right? So actually in the history itself, this is the first time that there is a decrease and fall down of tourism sector. That is from 2020 to 2021. Is it clear? This is in history also you can see this is the first time that there is a major decrease in tourism sector because of COVID-19 pandemic. Then now you see about World Tourism Day 27 September. We will come across, now we will discuss about theme, objective and date is on 27 September. Then tourism sector is having like major impact even on developed and developing countries, right? That means majorly on the economic growth. And as well as tourism sector will be helping also for the creating or generating the employment for youth, right, in that area. So these are the major benefits through the tourism sector. So now the purpose of this day, that means what is the object to celebrate this day, is to raise awareness on the role of tourism within the international community and to demonstrate how it affects. Just now we have said that there will be an impact on employment and even country's economy, right? So as well as social, cultural, political and economic values worldwide, right? So these are the major effects of tourism. And in the ongoing pandemic times, it is important to raise the awareness about the tourism sector, which is given 90% of World Heritage Sites closed as a result of this pandemic last year also, as we have came across this. and even young people in rural communities were unemployed, right? So even if there is, suppose if you take some of the tourism sector, right? So majorly many youth will be working there, right? That means employment will be created. But if that tourism sector got stopped, then major of the youth in that villages will be unemployed. If you see even north side also, major of the people will be like youth will be in employed sector, that is regarding your tourism sector. But because of this pandemic situation, many of them have even lost their jobs in this tourism sector and get unemployed. So now this is the time to know regarding how actually tourism sector is important for a country's economic development and as well as even social and cultural developments. Then if we move about the theme, actually the theme of World Tourism Day of 2021 is Tourism for Inclusive Growth. So why they have considered this theme inclusive growth? That means considering COVID-19 pandemic, this is the reason to select this appropriate theme of 2021. Is it clear? And as well as according to certain data regarding 2019, 2020, 2021, actually there is a decrease of 85%. Is it clear? That is in 2019 in the regarding tourism sector, there is a decrease of 85%. So with these numerical terms, you can get to know actually what is the impact of tourism sector on country's economy. Next, if we move, World Rivers 2021 celebrated on 26th September. So here you have to concentrate that actually the static part regarding 2021, it falls on 26 September. But every year, if the question is that about World Rivers Day will be celebrated every year on which day? Okay, so that is 4th Sunday of September. Make it clear itself. Again, don't be confused whenever the practice questions will be raised here. You have to concentrate whether they have mentioned 2021 or else every year. If they have mentioned every year, your answer should be 4th Sunday of September. If they have questioned you regarding 2021, your answer should be 26 September. Is it clear? Then from which year it has started to celebrate? It has started to celebrate since 2005. Then moving to the objective. Objective is about to raise the global awareness of the need to support, protect and preserve rivers around the world. As we have known and about these, to conservation and preservation of these rivers around the world. So this is and to get the bring the awareness about these importance of rivers, this day will be celebrated. And as well as just now I said you, if there is a question of 2021, then your answer should be 26 September. Then moving to the theme, actually the 2021 theme for World Rivers Day is waterways in our communities. Is it clear? And that is with the specific emphasis on the need to conserve and repair urban waterways and which are frequently under stress. As you have known, if you consider about rural areas, that will be somewhat fresh. Is it clear? But moving to the urban sector, there will be always under stress. Frequently, there will be under stress regarding this waterways. So there is a need to conserve and repair. That is why the major theme they have considered is waterways in our communities. So this is all about World Rivers Day. So you have to concentrate on the days. 4th Sunday of September is every year, but coming to 2021, 26 September. I am repeating twice and thrice because major of you people will be confused between these two areas. Is it clear? So with this, we have done with our 26th and 27th September current affairs. Thank you everyone. We will meet you in the next class. Until that, stay tuned.